Okay, welcome everyone to the CSAIR Un-Gala pre-show. We're excited tonight to see all of you, and we're going to kick it off by introducing Magical Dave for your entertainment pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Trick right now. Even though you're there and I'm here, or you're here and I'm there, we're going to do a trick and see if I can figure out where you are on this game board. So this is what you're going to do. Parents, you can help your child do it. And adults, you should try this too, because this is going to make it harder for me. So what you're going to do in a moment is you're going to put your finger on one of these squares, either this one, this one, this one, or this one. I actually want you to come up and touch your screen. Literally, I want you to touch your screen because I'm going to see if I can figure this out. So you're going to come up and you're going to touch either this one, or that one. So you can put your finger on one of those now. What you're going to do is I'm going to tell you to move a certain number of times. So for instance, if I say move four times, and let's say you're here, that's me. If I say move four times, you can go one, two, three, four. Or you could go one, two, three, four. Or you could go one, two, three, four. You could go top, up, down, left, right, right, left, bottom, top, but you can't go diagonal. All right, so let's try it out. Put your finger here, 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 or here, all right? Now what I want you to do is I want you to move four times. Move as I count. Ready? One, two, three, four. Keep your finger right there, okay? Now I'm gonna try to figure out where you are. Now, I know you're not here at this hat, so I'm going to take that away. Now keep your finger where you are. Now you're going to move another time. I'm going to tell you how many times in a second, but you can't move here. So this is an empty space. You can't move to the space, but you have eight other spots you can move. Ready? I want you to move five times. Move five as I count. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five. All right. I know you're not at this wizard, so I'm gonna take him away. Keep your finger where you are. I now want you to move two times. Ready? Go. One, two. Now I'm gonna try to figure out where you are. Well, I'm not gonna say you're here, even though I like this picture, you're not here. Now I want you to move, let's say, three times. Three more times. Ready? Go. One, two, three. The choices that you're moving are endless possibilities, but I know you're not here. And I know you're not here. There's only four squares left. I want you to move three times. Ready? Go. One, two, three. A moment ago, a lot of you were here, but you're not there anymore. All right, last turn. You got one place to move. Ready? Just move once. Ready? Go. Now keep your finger there. Remember, even though you're there and I'm here, probably all in Riverdale, maybe, I think I know where you are. You're not at the magic show here. You're not at this guy. You must be at Magical Dave. And that is where you are. All right. Excellent job. So this is what we're going to do. I'm gonna do another card trick for you guys. Really, really cool. This is gonna be a card trick that all of you can do. So let's see. Mason, can you unmute one person who can actually help with this trick? Can someone unmute themselves? No, that?
Yep, I'm here. I'm unmuted. How can I help?
Oh, perfect. Who is that?
That's Ellen.
Ellen, have we planned this trick before?
We have not.
Are you sure?
I'm definitely sure.
Perfect. Ellen, what I want you to do is I want you to say stop anytime you want, okay? Just say stop anytime.
Stop.
Right here? Look at the card, but don't say it. Everyone look at the card. You got it?
Got it.
All right. So I'm going to put the cards back. Ellen, I'm going to find your card right now. I'm going to do it in a really cool way. I'm going to draw it. Here we go. I want you to think of your card, Ellen. Ellen, do you live in Riverdale?
I do.
Perfect. So that's pretty close. I'm in Riverdale too, so I should be able to actually read your mind because it's not that far away. Here we go. I'm going to draw your card. Think of the card, please. You thinking of it?
Thinking of it.
All right, here we go, Ellen. This is pretty easy. Your card looks like that. All right?
Doing great, Magical Dave.
But that's it. It doesn't get any better than that. Does it look like that?
Yep, looks like that.
Okay, sorry. Here, for real. Ready, watch this. Think of your card, Ellen. There you go. Four of hearts. Is that it?
It wasn't.
Really?
Really.
You serious? No, you serious?
I'm serious.
It's okay. I don't mean like this is your card. I mean like, watch, I could do this. Put some dimensions. And there's like a box of cards. So your card is in this box, right? It's in like the deck. Yeah,
it's in the deck.
Okay, check this out, ready? I think I'm losing you here, Ellen. Watch. Watch very closely, watch the cards.
Yeah, I'm watching. Wow, I think that's my card.
Is that it, Ellen?
That is, how did you do that?
Excellent job, Ellen. Thank you very much for helping. That was great. We're gonna actually, try right now for the kids. I'm gonna need some helpers to make Marshmallow the bunny rabbit appear. We're gonna make Marshmallow appear right here. So everybody, I want you to go like this. We're gonna make Marshmallow appear. Do you know what this does? Everyone, adults too, we need everyone to do this. It's not that hard to do this. Do you know what this does? Nothing, it looks nice though. So go like this. Yep, and magic words. What are the magic words? Not have a banana. Oh, abracadabra. Yes, we're going to make Marshmallow appear. We're going to say abracadabra. So everyone say abracadabra. Ready, go. Let's see if it works. If we can make Marshmallow appear. Oh, look at this. Look what we have. It worked. This is Marshmallow the bunny. Everyone say hi, Marshmallow. He's going to give you a little kiss. Marshmallow is only 4 years old. This is as big as Marshmallow gets. He's a really, really cute bunny. Marshmallow loves to watch a magic show, so I'm gonna leave Marshmallow right over here. And we got something really cool to do. Since this is a magic show, and I like to think all magic shows are parties, we're gonna make a cake. So if you have a kid here who likes to bake, I want you to tell them to think of something you need to make a cake. What is one ingredient you need to make a cake? So think of an ingredient. I'm gonna pour in some magic ingredients here. Make a chocolate cake, because I love chocolate cake. All right, here we go. So if you're thinking of a cake, chocolate cake, everyone hold up some flour and throw in some flour. Yeah, everyone throw in some flour and throw in some oil and water and baking soda and sugar. Do you like sugar? No, yes, throw in some sugar, yeah. An egg, throw in an egg, but not the shell. Perfect. Chocolate cake. Oh, chocolate frosting, maybe? Anything. Butter, throw in some butter. All right. So we're going to try to make a chocolate cake. Watch. Here we go. Everyone blow on the pan. You say abracadabra, watch. One, two, three. We have made a chocolate cake. Look at this delicious cake. This is so delicious. A chocolate cake. Yep. We have a nice chocolate cake here. It's a, what? It's a cake. Yes, it's a cake. And we have the nice chocolate cake. Yep. What? Oh, it's a snake. This is not a cake. This is a snake. This is Fluffy the snake. Everyone say hi, Fluffy. Yeah, this is Fluffy. Fluffy's a very friendly snake. Fluffy's a ball python. He's about 5.5 feet long. Fluffy's very friendly. And I'm actually going to show you, Fluffy is a ball python, which means it likes to curl up into a little ball. So I'm going to put Fluffy here. And Fluffy and Marshmallow, they're not friends. So I'm going to leave Fluffy over here. And I'm going to put Marshmallow over there. All right, we're going to do one more trick. One more trick we're going to do. And can we get one more per person to help out with this trick? Maybe someone else could be unmuted and we could try one more trick for the last trick. Who can be a helper here? Mason, can you unmute one person possible? Or I could do it. Let's see. Who's going to be the victim? I mean, volunteer. Sorry. How about, yeah. Oh, we got someone?
We did. That's
us.
That's
good. Perfect. Here we go. Last trick I'm going to do. I want you to, who's doing this?
See?
Go ahead, Noah.
Us.
Okay, us. I want us. Say stop anytime. Here we go. Say stop.
Stop.
Look at that card. You got it?
Yep.
I'm going to find the card. Watch this. I'm going to find it. Check this out really quickly. This is a last trick, so it's got to be good. If this doesn't work, don't remember my name. Here we go. I'm going to try to figure out what the card is. I'm going to make it jump right to the top of the deck. Ready? Watch. 1, 2, 3. And the card, 7 of hearts. Thank you very much. Is that it?
No.
You need 3 people to say no? Okay, great. All right, let's try it again. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Now, is that it?
5, yes.
5 of hearts?
Yeah.
No.
What are you playing? Someone say yes? No? Okay, we'll try again. I get 3 turns. Here we go. No, not that one. This one. Is that it?
No.
Really?
Okay, look at it.
Okay, let me try one more time. I'll do it like this. Watch.
No.
No.
No. Yuck!
What was the card? Is it this?
Yes!
Alright. You can keep these cards. Yay. I'll send this to you.
Thanks for watching my show.
I hope you had a good time. Thanks. I hope you enjoy the rest of the event. Have a good night. My name's Magical Dave. Take care.
Wow, thank you so much, Magical Dave. That was amazing. Let's give it up for Magical Dave.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right. So thanks, everyone, for joining us. We're going to actually turn to playing our ad journal until we start our formal program. So please stay tuned. We'll be back shortly.
You want to come over here, then? Because if you're just plugged in.
No. So you guys can stay.
All right, maybe I'll go into another room.
Good evening and welcome to the CSAIR 2020 Vision Un-Gala. My name is Ellen Goldberg and I am thrilled to be co-chairing this event with Bernie Goldstein. Originally, Bernie and I were planning to chair CSAIR's in-person annual gala in June. The goal of the gala was to raise funds for the synagogue and bring the community together for a really fun social event. Unfortunately, everything was put on hold in mid-March due to the coronavirus pandemic. Just 6 weeks ago, Cliff Nerwin reached out and suggested we plan a virtual event instead. So here we are, hosting CSAIR's first Un-Gala. While the format of the gala has changed, the goals of the event remain the same. Our vision for the Un-Gala was to support the synagogue financially, unite the congregation at a time when we are physically distant, and celebrate what makes our community special. Thanks to your generosity, we have surpassed our fundraising goal and raise more than $33,000 in UN-tickets and gala ads at the start of tonight's Zoom event. You can still donate and participate in tonight's live auction to help us raise even more. These funds will go directly to CSAIR's operating costs and support programs at the shul. Tonight is all about supporting, uniting, and celebrating our community. And our program reflects that. Throughout the evening, we will have music, words of Torah, stories, and dancing, all featuring the members and clergy of CSAIR. We are truly blessed to have such a talented, caring, and passionate community, and that will be on full display in our program tonight. Now I'd like to introduce my co-chair, Bernie Goldstein, to share our plans for the evening.
Thank you, Ellen. Good evening, everyone. The hard work of fundraising is behind us, and now it's time to celebrate. So good evening, everyone. We have a great lineup of videos, singing with congregants. We have our rabbi, Rabbi Katz, who will give some words of Torah. And we have a great program all the way throughout, including trivia, including a live auction, so please stay tuned. Before we get to it, two things I want to cover. First of all, Ellen and I want to specifically thank some people who made all of this possible. As always, anything good takes a village to accomplish. So thank you to our professional leadership, Rabbi Katz, Cantor Stevens, Mason Voigt, who is behind the scenes making this Zoom run tonight, Rabbi Katie Greenberg, who did so much of the heavy lifting alongside of us, is a key part of the team. Ben Freed, Nancy Brickman, Stephanie Tavares, Thank you so much for all of your help. We also want to thank our terrific lay leadership, Cliff Nerwin, the president of CSAIR, who helped us along the way, the board of the synagogue, who were critical to the fundraising efforts, and of course, the many talented congregants who will be featured in tonight's program. As Ellen referenced, we have an auction tonight. I've got my gavel. We are ready to break through $31,000 and raise some more money to support our shul. And we have some exciting prizes. Prize package number one, this was all in the email on the website. It's a catered dinner for 10 people with Rabbi Katz, including Rabbi Katz. Catering will be provided by Foremost Ram Caterers, New York area's premier Glock kosher caterer, and in the running if we had had a live gala. What are you looking forward to after the restrictions are lifted? Imagine a special birthday, an anniversary, a chag, a gathering of family or friends. How much better would it be with a catered meal and the Torah and company of Rabbi Katz? Truly a night to remember. The starting bid for this night to remember is $750, and we hope it will only go up from there. And we want to thank Bob Jacobs and his family for generously donating this prize package. If that doesn't appeal to you, or maybe you want to buy a second prize package, we have redesigned your career or job search with a package of 5 customized career coaching sessions from a Columbia University trained and bow tie wearing executive coach. This is the perfect gift for a new grad or an experienced job seeker. Are you or someone you love currently looking for a new role? Are you trying to navigate the choppy economic waters and thrive, not just survive? Then this package of 5 customized sessions is just what you need. Our opening bid for this package is $500, and it's been donated by Goldstein Professional Development. So just a couple housekeeping items on the auction. How do you bid? I'm sure you're all ready to bid. How do you do it? Simply open the chat on your Zoom. You can see, right, if you touch the screen on an iPad or you look in the dock on your laptop, you will see more, and you'll be able to open the chat. When you open the chat, you type in your first and last name. You type in the name of the prize package you're bidding on. You could say dinner or coaching, and then you type in the amount of your bid. You can bid as a team. Just make sure there's only one person bidding for your group, otherwise you'll be bidding against yourselves. And then also please make sure that the bid amount you enter is higher than the previous bid. That is super important as well. So we hope as the night goes on, you'll be paying attention to the wonderful program, but also opening up that chat and bidding. I'll rejoin later in the program to finalize our live auction. Let's keep the chat lively. Let's keep our bids high and continue to support our shul. I want to thank the co-chair, Ellen Goldberg. Pleasure working with you. And now, l'chaim, everyone. Let's get started with the celebration. Cantor Stevens, would you please kick off our first video?
Yes. So as we've said, the gala is a time to celebrate this incredible community. Every year, we thank and honor people who have been generous with their time and their talents. This year, we're having somewhat of a focus on essential workers and also just on each other for helping each other to get through this crazy time. So I asked people to send in some photos. I'm holding up signs, either thanking the essential workers in their lives, in their community, or saying something that they missed or love about the synagogue. So here's mine for my children. Oh, it's backwards. I'll read it. I miss the book bin. I miss the cookies. I miss the rabbi's candy. And this is mine. I miss singing with you. And since I miss singing with you, I tried to recreate. It's the thing that you can do a lot of things on Zoom. It's kind of an amazing tool. Communal singing is really a challenge. Oh, by the way, I wanted to figure out how to be fancy when people were only going to see my head. So this is what me and my daughter came up with. I really missed singing with all of you. And so we tried to create the sound of a shul singing one of our favorite nigunim together, along with images of people holding up their signs that tell us what they love and miss about the synagogue. So please enjoy.
La 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 la.
Wow, that was amazing. That was amazing. I loved hearing everybody's voices. As Akantra said, it's one of the things that I miss the most is hearing us all sing together. And thank you, Akantra Stevens and Dasi, for helping put all that together. It is wonderful to come together tonight to celebrate. I want to thank Ellen and Bernie for all of your work and for your belief that we could do this, have a gala without being in the same place, without the food and without the music, and that it would all still feel gala. I want to thank you and so many other people who've pitched in and contributed and generally helped generate excitement around this evening. And of course, I also want to thank Nancy Brickman and Stephanie Tavares and Rabbi Greenberg and Kendra Stevens and Mason Voigt and Wilson Menya and Jose Quinones and Ben Fried and Ben Perlstein and Wilson's staff and all of our Hebrew school and youth workers and our exec and our board for all of your extraordinary efforts leading up to today and for the last 3 months. I miss us being in the same place. And of course, I want to thank our fearless and pretty tireless leader, Dr. Cliff Nerwin. The ability to imagine something that doesn't exist, for example, a buildingless gala, is not a simple thing. It requires the willingness to let your mind explore possibilities, right? To kind of think about it. And then as you're doing that, to willingly set aside the inevitable objections or problems that you'll face as you will that new thing into being. To respond to that voice in your head that says, no way, this will not work, and say, I hear you, and we'll respond, but just give me a minute to be in the new place, to adjust, to imagine its possibilities. The Torah reading for this week tells the story of scouts who are sent to spy out the land of Israel. All of them come back with an honest report, but 10 of them question whether the Israelites can ever question the land and thrive in it. And only two say, Yachol Nuchala, we can do this. Over the last 3 months, we have all been scouts in worlds that we could not have imagined. For a few weeks, we were asked to think about what it would mean to start to close down our institutions, our businesses, schools, enter our homes for a protracted period of time. And then with very little lead time, we had to do all of this. We didn't have a lot of time to imagine ourselves in this new world. But in this new world, we were sometimes the 10 scouts. There were moments when we felt like grasshoppers in our own eyes, unequal to the task. When we felt overwhelmed by forces that felt to us like inscrutable and menacing giants. Often people paint those 10 spies as villains with little faith in God. But this year, I just see them as people who are petrified. People who could not, like some of us, who could not silence the voice that said, no way, I can't do this. And there were times over the last 3 months when, as scouts in this new world, we were actually Caleb and Yoshua, Caleb and Joshua. We were the two who said, Yachol Nuchala, we can do this, because we took care of our families and our community and our city and our country and our world. Our essential workers kept on showing up to do the hard work of keeping us healthy and fed. They made sure that our kids were taught, that the buses ran, that the supply chains that could run did run, and so much more. In this new place, there were even times when we experienced joy, when we could really be in this new place and say, you know what, it's a good place. A Zoom birthday party, it's not the same, but it can be really sweet, or a class, or a Friday Night Live. In our Emunah groups, we met new people, and we were reminded of the power of chesed, of small acts of loving kindness again and again. And now we're being asked to scout out a new world, the world of, quote, opening up. Tonight after our gala is the first evening minyan in 3 months. It will be live for 10 people and Zoomed for everyone else who wants to be part of this small but historic event. You can check your emails for the details. And I imagine that as things open up, there will be times when each of us experience the emotions of the 10 scouts and of the 2 scouts. We will be both fearful and optimistic. I hope that we don't let our fear define us. And I hope also that we're not cavalier about the things that one should fear, but it's a hard balance. Things will be different in this in-between world, and we really can't say how exactly for the shul. We'll continue to rely on our amazingly grounded and expert advice that we receive from our medical advisory committee and from the Department of Health as we plan the summer, the holidays, and beyond. We will enter this new world and the next and the next and the next together. We will go with the people who feel comfortable venturing out now and the ones who will need to wait a bit longer. We will enter this new world with our incredible volunteers and staff. We will go with kindness. We will do everything we can to make this new time a time of growth and energy for our community. In our lives, we're often called upon to be scouts, about to enter new lands that we don't know. It happens as we age, as we mark life cycle events, as we move into new jobs, relationships, schools, and more. It happens in the life of our nation and people. We know this from the last few weeks as our nation was reminded of the price we pay for racism. As individuals and as a community, we are always being called to scout out new lands, to imagine ourselves in it, and to decide, is it good? Or even better, can we make it good? Many of you know Rabbi Shlomo Balter, my immediate predecessor, an inspiring mentor and teacher who helped make our shul what it is. But there are probably only a few of you on this call who remember Rabbi Chaim Perl. I never met Rabbi Perl. He was Rabbi Balter's predecessor, but I once read some notes he took on the story of the scouts. It was all written in his handwriting. So he was writing in the late 40s and 50s in England, and he comments that just after the story of the spies, the very next chapter begins, "Speak to the children of Israel and say to them, when you enter the land to settle in." His handwritten notes offer the following observation, and I won't try to imitate his English accent. Incongruous! This is an assurance that although that generation would perish, the people of Israel would not cease to exist. Just a chapter ago, we were wondering if we could enter the land, and now this ancient promise will be fulfilled, if not with you, then with your descendants. It's telling that not 10 years after World War II, and the Blitz in London, which he survived, and the Shoah, Rabbi Perl adds these notes, the importance of tikvah, of hope for each Jew. With its problems, Jewry must take the long view, if not in this generation, then in the next. And here we are, making a gala over Zoom. If not in this generation, then in the next. That is part of what it takes to enter a new land. It takes hope, it takes tikvah. I believe in our shul, I believe in each one of you. I certainly hope and pray for an end to this pandemic, but until then, I want us to cultivate another kind of hope, that we can continue to respond to whatever happens with determination, a thoughtful spirit of experimentation, and an appreciation of the many needs that exist in a community like ours. This has always been our strength. And though these strengths have been tested in the past few months, I believe that we can thrive this year. The form might need to change, but we can continue to reach the lofty goals set by our synagogue's mission statement, to nourish joyful and meaningful Jewish living and build an inclusive community through diverse approaches to learning, prayer, and acts of loving kindness. Yachol Nucha. We can do this together. Mazel tov, everybody.
And now for something completely different. Welcome to the wildly irreverent and moderately popular, Shul Trivia. This week, we are going to be playing Guess That Baby, where it's all made up and the points don't matter, just like what we're wearing below the shoulders tonight. So, I am going to share my screen. And we are going to get going. So, here's how this is going to work. There is going to be a baby that is going to come onto the screen. If you think you know who that baby is, I'm able to see y'all even though you can't see me through the powers of being the one who's sharing my screen. So if you think you know who the baby is, start waving your hands around in the air, jumping up and down, throwing small children, whatever you need to do to get my attention, and I will call on you and unmute you, and you will be able to guess that baby. So for our fabulous, fabulous prizes. So here is baby number one. So if you think you know who this baby is, oh, wait, I see Leba Kornfeld is waving her hands wildly Leba, I'm unmuting you. I tried to unmute you. There you go.
I think it's the canter.
You think it's the canter, and you are right. We have a correct first answer. Mazel tov, Leba. You win. You can stop by the shul and pick up a free kippah, which can be used as a face mask. Disclaimer, not actually approved by medical professionals. So, baby number one is Cantor Elizabeth Stevens. All right, now on to baby number two. If you think you know who baby number two is, by the way, these can be staff members or lay leaders. The Spivaks are waving their arms. 1 second, I'm gonna unmute you. I'm trying to unmute you, Spivaks. Unmute. There you go, Spivaks, who is it?
You think it's Cliff.
You think it's Cliff, and you're right. We have some very astute members in our community here. You think it's Cliff. Your amazing prize, oh, actually, one of you already won this prize, but it's a seat on the board of the shul, and you are not allowed to decline. So, mazel tov to you. Congratulations. All righty. Moving on to our next baby. Who do we have here? All right, if you think you know who it is, a shul staff member or lay leader, if you think you know who it is, start waving your hands around. I'm not seeing any waves. Oh, wait. One of the Schwabs, the Notkin Schwabs of the Schwab clan. Who do we think
is it a Stephanie?
It is a Stephanie. We have all right guesses so far. Really incredible. The Notkin Schwabs win an opportunity to reserve tickets to next year's gala. So congratulations, you can do that right at the conclusion of this event. Mazel tov. All right, we have applause, I see, from some folks out in the audience. We have a Stephanie. All right, moving on to our next baby. Again, these are lay leaders and shul staff members. Start waving your arms around wildly if you think you know who this is. Oh, wait, Abby Pitkowski. Abby, I'm unmuting you. I'm trying to unmute you. Go
okay,
ahead.
Okay, I'm gonna go for Nancy Brickman.
No, this is not Nancy Brickman. No. All right, we're going to try to get one more guess, and then I might start helping people. Let's see. Who do we have? Who's waving their hands? Anybody waving? Oh, wait. Yep. All right. I'm unmuting you. Go ahead.
Barry Katz?
That is not Barry Katz. A decent guess. Think perhaps someone who's more closely related to what's happening tonight. Someone who's very invested in tonight's event. No? Okay. Razel. All right. I'm calling on you. I'm unmuting you.
Is it Mason?
It is not Mason. No.
Ah.
Yes. Someone who's very, perhaps a lay leader who really thinks that tonight is really important. Yes. Go. I'm unmuting you. Go ahead.
Is it Ellen?
It is Ellen. Mazel tov. Ellen Goldberg, our co-host tonight. Your prize is one free rubber chicken. Both Mason and myself collect rubber chickens, so you'll be able to get one. Contact me afterwards for your amazing rubber chicken prize. All right, next baby. Start waving your hands if you think you know who this is. Start waving your hands. Oh, I see a different Schwab clan, the Rezik Schwabs. I'm trying to unmute you. There you go.
Sarita and I think it's Rabbi Katz.
Both Sarita and you are correct. This is Rabbi Barry Dov Katz. And based on the picture, and I haven't talked to Rabbi Katz about this, but I'm giving you a free piano concert from Rabbi Katz. So you're gonna have to talk to him about claiming that. He knows nothing about this, so I don't know when or how exactly that will happen. Alrighty, moving on to our next baby. Alrighty, this one's a tough one. This one's an early baby picture. Oh wait, I have a wave. I'm unmuting you. Go ahead.
Wilson.
Well, it's not Wilson. Wilson, but a good guess. I'll give you a hint. It is a lay leader. It's a lay leader in the community. Looking for hands waving. Oh wait, I saw a hand wave. Who is it? Yes, go ahead, I'm unmuting you. Something should pop up that says go for it.
Abby Pitkowski.
That is Abby Pitkowski. Congratulations. That looks like the Abrams Gerbers. Amazing job. You win our next incredible prize. which is you get to park your car on whichever side of the street you want. Offer only good until June 21st. So congratulations, mazel tov to you. All right, moving smartly ahead to our next baby. Abby Pinkowski. All right, this one might be a little easier. Looking for some waving hands. Wait, you're not you don't get to guess twice, Speedax. All right, Amy Levine. I can't hear you. You're unmuted, but I can't hear you. All righty. Okay, we're gonna go on to somebody else. Somebody waving their hand. Oh, yep, Anita.
Rabbi Greenberg.
That is Rabbi Greenberg. You have a very astute eye. your prize is that you get access to hours of amazing content of Jewish educational and entertainment material. To claim your prize, go to CSAIR.org, and then you click on video recordings to see all of the amazing video recordings we've had from all of our CSAIR programs over the past few months. So mazel tov to you. It's an amazing prize. And in fact, everyone can take advantage of that prize. So go on our website and check out all the amazing things we've been up to. All right. Next. All right, who's this dapper young man? Oh, wait, I see a lot of waving going on down here. Yes, I unmuted you.
Okay.
Ben Freed, it's you.
No, it's not me.
What?
Yes, it's a fellow bow tie wearing person. Who could it be? Yes, go ahead. I think, is that Fran? I think that's Fran. Fran, I'm trying to unmute you. You might have to unmute yourself.
Mason?
It's not Mason. We're looking for a lay leader here, actually. Yes, Miriam Westheimer. Oh, trying to unmute you. You're still muted. Oh, nope. You're still muted. There you go.
Bernie Goldstein.
It is Bernie Goldstein. You are absolutely right. Mazel tov. You win our next fabulous prize, which is a Facebook shout out, which you will then share with all of your friends and encourage people to like our Facebook page. So it's a win-win situation. Contact me, you and your mother are both very, very qualified for that. All righty. We have just a couple more left, a couple more. All right, who is this fellow? Any guesses? No guesses. No one. I'm not. Oh, wait. Mateo's not waving his hand. Who? It's a really good-looking person. Great personality. Yes, the Talibs. What? Sorry, I'm trying to unmute you.
Is it you?
It is me. I don't know. Yes. Very, very impressive. You win our amazing prize. Borrowed from Wait, Wait, Don't Tell Me, a CSAIR staff member of your choice will record your answering machine for you.
Oh, so, wow.
CSAIR staff member record your answering machine. Mazel tov. Contact me later to collect your prize. All right, just two more left. We're almost out of folks. All right. This is someone who is a lay leader who's very active on Shabbat morning. So we have a waving hand. I see you there. I'm unmuting you. I can't see who it is because you're waving your hand in front of your face.
Sorry, it's Greg and Kathy. That looks like Amy Levine.
That is Amy Levine. A first guess, nailed it. And as it is Amy Levine, your prize is an Aliyah, your first time.
Wow.
Over. Mazel tov. Make sure you redeem that prize. I look forward to seeing y'all there. All right, and now our final baby. Our final baby. And this one comes with a prize that's a real prize. So I not that the other ones weren't real, of course, but looking for any hands waving, looking for hands waving. Anyone who thinks they know who this is. Oh, yep, Nadine.
Is that Wilson?
It is not Wilson. It's a good guess. Think of someone else who works in the office. Nadine, I was giving you a second shot at this. No,
Nancy?
It is Nancy. Nailed it. All right, Nadine, you win a free copy of the book White Fragility. We are all going to be reading White Fragility as part of a Riverdale-wide reading project over the next couple of months. And CSAIR is really excited to announce that we have ordered 100 books from a Black-owned bookstore in Brooklyn. So you will be getting more information about this tonight so that you can order through us and come pick up your books at Shul so everyone saves on shipping. But Nadine, you get to pick up your book for free. So Mazel Tov, congratulations.
Fantastic.
Thank you everyone for playing Guess That Baby. It's been a pleasure playing with all of you. We're now gonna see some really, really incredible videos of some congregants talking about how much CSAIR means to them. So first we are going to hear from Michelle Weber-Cohen.
Hi everyone, my name is Michelle Cohen. I am a proud member of the CSAIR community and a longstanding researcher for clinical trials at Mount Sinai. In my role as the director of the clinical trials office, I lead a team to treat many different clinical trials for various diseases. After the COVID-19 surge began, it was clear that randomized clinical trials became a critical pathway to treat these hospitalized patients. In the past 100 days, we began 8 different clinical trials and treated hundreds of patients. In early March, I was asked to help with an emergency use application for a possible treatment for COVID-19 called remdesivir. The medication was not FDA approved and required special and lengthy approval process. We could only initiate treatment after all documents were signed and the FDA issued an emergency use approval for each patient. Thankfully, we submitted 19 emergency IND applications. Patients ranged from a 10-year-old to pregnant women, all the way to an octogenarian. Not all patients survived, most did. The hardest part, I think, was working around the clock to get the patients treated so they might have a chance to survive. The treatment period was 10 days. I watched them closely in the electronic medical record. When their lab values improved, we cheered. When they came off of the breathing tube, we cheered. We cried tears of joy when the first patient was released from the hospital after 60 long days. I also cried tears of sadness when someone did not survive, or a patient in their 30s was left in the hospital on a ventilator and transferred to a long-term rehab facility. Another highlight for me was being able to help our pulmonary team. They were trying to transform sleep apnea machines into breathing machines to prevent a shortage. However, they were short 13 computer power cords. They asked if anyone had these power cords. I quietly sent a note telling them that my brother-in-law works for Amazon and could have these in 2 days, which really helped because per their delivery timeline, it would take 21 days. I love making mountains move quietly by helping others. When I think back to the past 100 days, I think my biggest takeaways from this experience, I couldn't have done this without the ongoing support of Rafi and understanding and genuine curiosity of our kids. I've not been as present as I want to, but I know this is temporary. For the first time in 27 years, I missed Minyan in Shul for my mother's yard site, and it's okay. I have had conversations, driveway dates, porch hangouts, hiking expeditions with family and members of this community, and this has given me energy. I have felt the love from the emails, the texts, the Facebook posts, the care packages from many people, including the freshly made babka mailed from a deal friend in Ohio. Being a Rosh Hashanah at Camp Ramah in the Poconos for a small group of 80 campers and 20 staff members have given me the many project management skills that I use every single day. I love working in clinical trials and will continue to partner with our team. I believe clinical research will continue to change how medicine is treated and provide options for COVID-19 until we have a viable and available vaccine for all. I really miss going to this shul. This is the longest I have ever gone without stepping into a synagogue, and yet I still feel part of a wonderful community. Thank you. I truly look forward to the day when this is all behind us and we can move forward as humanity.
Wow. Thank you so, so much, Michelle. those really, really beautiful words. And now we're gonna hear from Stephen Gleit.
Greetings, my name is Steve Gleit, and I am the volunteer leader of Emunah Group 19. I wanna thank Rabbis Katz and Greenberg for starting this program. I want to also thank Abby Pitkowski for answering all my questions over the last several months to make our group very successful. Thank you. There are 13 people in our group, nine of which regularly participate in a weekly Zoom. Many in our group, including myself and my wife, Dana, are relatively new members, and we have welcomed the opportunity to get to know one another while we shelter in place. Here are some comments from our group regarding the program. One, terrific to connect as new members with other new members who are also neighbors in our Riverdale community. Two, great way to overcome isolation. Three, credit to our synagogue to provide us this opportunity to meet new people. Four, the Emunah Group provides a glimpse into the diverse membership of CSAIR. And lastly, the members of our group would never have met but for the Emunah Group program. We are very thankful for that. Thanks.
All righty, wow. Such amazing, amazing words also from Steve. Thank you so much, both to you and Michelle. For moving mountains and for bringing people together. It's really, really amazing. So now, to bring our community together, we heard some amazing song coming together from the Cantor earlier. We're now gonna get to see all of your dance moves when we play some Hora music. We're gonna do some celebratory dancing. We wanna see your best Hora moves in your own living room, office, bedroom, whatever you happen to be Zooming from. And you will pop up on the screen. It's kind of our version of the Hora cam, if you will. So Mason is going to play the music and we are all gonna get our boogie on.
We'll be right back.
Hi, everybody. So wonderful to see all of you dancing and having so much fun. So wonderful always to see all your faces. So Maya and I wanted to introduce the next videos we're going to hear from two congregants who had bar and bat mitzvahs during this crazy time. So first, we're going to hear from Dr. Nadine Cohen.
Kindness goes the distance. Have you ever thrown a stone into a pond? And after the stone sinks into the water, a ripple effect is triggered. Concentric circles form and extend well beyond the place where the stone hit the water. This image resonates with me, and it comes to represent kindness over the last several months. It represents my experience over this period of time, whether I've experienced it as a physician, a mother, a community member, or a member of CSAIR, whether it's been in connection with friends, strangers, patients, family members, peers in the healthcare profession, or in other communities that surround us. There are many moments and experiences I could point to and think of when I think about this stone hitting the water and the ripple effects that have launched from just one act. I think of the ICU physician at St. John's Riverside here in Yonkers who, despite being inundated with an overwhelming number of patients, 54 patients for whom he was in charge of the care on ventilators, and he was fighting for each one of those lives, and he took the time to speak with me, collaborate with me in an effort to work towards helping one friend and the other patients who surrounded him. He had the willingness and the openness, an act of kindness in and of itself that created reverberations that certainly impacted me, but more importantly impacted many patients and their families. I think of a Shabbat where a neighbor, a rabbi, a representative from the New York Blood Center, an acquaintance from another town, Maddie, all came together to help find plasma for a woman who was a stranger to all of us. And I think of Maddie's virtual bat mitzvah. That was also a series of acts of kindness. Whether it was the professional staff of CSAIR being willing and open to different ideas, including having a safer Torah in our home, or crafting an amazing slideshow, or just being there for us when we were having to do this pivot from what we had thought of to what became. And what became actually became a series of circles of kindness and ripples of effect that led to us feeling tremendous love and connection despite the virtual medium. So all the people who participated, the members of our shul community, of CSAIR, our family, our friends, they enveloped us in a way with their own sweetness and kindness that created a series of circles that we all felt that day. So mitzvah gereret mitzvah, that came to life during this pandemic for me. One act led to a tremendous impact on many others. So my hope is that this ripple effect, as it continues to impact me personally and those around us, that willingness and openness to do acts of kindness will continue and really go the distance.
So thank you so much for those beautiful words, Nadine, and reminding us that every act of kindness, small or large, makes a huge difference. Okay, and next we're going to have Barry Stern and Deborah Shapira.
It was about mid-March when we started thinking that Matan's bar mitzvah wouldn't be exactly what we had planned. Right away, we had mixed emotions about this. On the one hand, we wouldn't have the pleasure and joy of having everyone we love gather in one place to celebrate with us. We wouldn't get to kvel with our family and friends as Matan led services and read Torah, And we wouldn't get to honor our family and friends in the way Jews do it best, by serving enormous amounts of food.
Our immediate natural reaction was disappointment. This all amounted to a sense of real loss. We had already celebrated the bat mitzvahs of Matan's sisters, Pearl and Kayla, so we knew what to expect and were really excited to do the same for Matan. But we'd also be lying if we said that there wasn't also a sense of relief. We thought of the money we'd save by not hiring a caterer or buying flowers. We thought of the time we would save by not needing to attend to 1,000 small details leading up to the weekend. And Matan was very honest right from the beginning, saying that he wasn't disappointed that he wouldn't have to read Torah in front of hundreds of people.
Nevertheless, as the date of the bar mitzvah neared, even as it became clear that out-of-town family and friends would not be able to travel to New York and we would not be able to invite a couple of hundred people to gather in shul, we still hoped against hope that we would be able to have some kind of celebration in shul on Shabbat with Matan reading from the Torah and receiving a blessing from Rabbi Katz and Cantor Stevens. We dreamed that maybe, just maybe, the shul building would be reopened and small gatherings would be allowed by the time the bar mitzvah rolled around on May 16th. When the governor ordered the lockdown to continue until May 15th, we finally accepted the truth that there would be no in-person gathering of any kind to celebrate Matan and his accomplishments.
We felt a little lost, a little deflated, and we didn't particularly want to be the pioneers who figure out how a weekend of fun, joyous events translates into an hour on a screen. So we were relieved to discover that, in fact, we weren't the first, and that Rabbi Katz, Cantor Stevens, and Mason had already been old pros at this. Zoom bar mitzvahs were still different, but no longer unique. We were extremely grateful that we were able to learn from the wisdom of Rabbi Katz, Cantor Stevens, and Mason, who had gained a lot of experience in a very short time and knew just what to do and say to help us craft a ritual that was both celebratory and meaningful to us, even on video.
Still, we thought, who is going to join a Zoom bar mitzvah? We shouldn't have wondered because of who this community is. And there you were, the friends that we're used to seeing every Shabbat, the ones who would have been kvelling right along with us to be led by Matan through Shacharit and to hear him read Torah for you. We couldn't have anticipated it, but the experience of seeing our community, our friends, our family come together by Zoom, it wasn't the same as a gathering in person, of course, but the feelings it generated for us were exactly the same. Joy, closeness, warmth, love. The sadness and disappointment were gone because of what our community brought to us through the screen that evening.
All right, what an amazing program so far. I hope everybody is having fun. I hope everybody is feeling inspired. So don't go anywhere. I know the hour is getting late, but we have two more exciting things for you. We're going to wrap up our auction right now and then immediately go to our final video, which you definitely don't want to miss. So please stay where you are. Okay, so now is your chance to support the shul and take home an amazing prize package. Right now, the current high bid actually just came in on the chat. For the dinner for 10 with Rabbi Katz, the Ken Gable team just outbid Mitch and Susan. The current high bid is $2,000. $2,000 by the Ken Gable team, which I know includes Bob Jacobs and many others. Mitch and Susan or anyone else, what say you? Can we go higher than $2,000? We have $2,000. How about $2,200? Anyone have $2,200 for this great dinner with Rabbi Katz? And I believe Shoshi will be joining also, and eight of your friends. Okay, $2,000. Mitch and Susan, do you want to type in the chat? Would you like a second dinner if we could swing it? Could we do two dinners? Can we do two dinners? Will you guys do $2,000 for a second dinner for two? Let's see. Mitch and Susan, do you guys want to jump in? $2,000. We can do two dinners. Two dinners, half the chulent for each of you, all the time with Rabbi Katz. Okay, no. So, Ken Gable team, $2,000. The gavel is high. Going once, going twice, going three times. Sold to the Ken Gable team, including Bob Jacobs. A wonderful dinner with Rabbi Katz. Bob is saying Shoshi better join or the deal is off. We'll see about that. But enjoy your dinner with Foremost Caterers. And then we'll try one more time. Does anyone want to enter the minimum bid, $500 for the coaching sessions? Do we have any bidders on that? Okay. All right. With that, let me turn it to Cantor Stevens. Thank you, Rabbi. Thank you, Bob Jacobs, for the donation. I'm sure you'll enjoy that dinner. And now let's go to Cantor Stevens to introduce our final video.
Thank you. So this experience of living through a pandemic has been full of fear and full of anxiety. And yet we've been able, as you've heard, to come together for celebrations. And celebrations that weren't just pretending to be happy, not just play acting or a shadow of happiness, but real joy, real celebration, real happiness, even in the midst of such fear, and even in the midst of the turmoil that our country is going through. During all of this, I want to especially thank Dasi Rosencrantz Cabo and her family. She had the audacity to suggest that we do a musical tribute to happiness during all of this. And she reminded me, mitzvah gedola liyot besimcha. It's a mitzvah to be happy, to find the joy in our lives, even in the dark times. So Dasi and her incredibly talented family, Richie, her children, Noga, Adam, and Zohar, have put together an incredibly joyful celebration of happiness, which I now pass on to you.
Don't worry, be happy. She's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space.
With the air like I don't care, baby, by the way.
Because I'm clap along if you feel like a room without a roof.
Because I'm
clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Clap along if you feel like that's what you
wanna
do.
Here come bad news, talking this and that.
Yeah. Give me all you got, don't hold back.
Yeah.
Well, I should probably warn you, I'll be just fine.
To you, don't waste your time. Here's why.
Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof.
Because I'm
clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth.
Because I'm
clap along if you know what happiness is to you.
Because I'm
clap along if you feel like that's what you got.
Happy, 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 happy.
song I wrote. Sing it note for note, don't worry. Be happy.
Wow, that was amazing. Team, for your performance of our shul and how together we are even more fabulous. This wraps up our program for tonight. We are so grateful to our professional and lay leadership, the congregants who shared their personal stories, and the amazing talent in tonight's program. CSAIR. I couldn't end this without acknowledging Bernie Goldstein, who held my hand through this whole thing because I'm really very nervous public speaker. It was such a pleasure to share this evening with you, and we can't wait to see you again so he can share our.
Thank you, Ellen. That was awesome. Couldn't have done it without you either. Appreciate your dedication. So as of tonight, we are at $33,722 in ticket and ad sales. 100% of the proceeds is going to the shul's operating budget, plus the $2,000 from the auction brings us to $35,722, and 100 plus people on the Zoom and our beautiful community together. So thank you all. Mazel tov and l'chaim again. Hope to see all of you soon.